on this edition of Size, Eyes, and the Skies.
The snow has started to push out of the state. We'll talk about totals and tell you what the week ahead shows coming up.
And Colleen Melberg is in the station right now, continuing to talk about the snowstorm that went across the United States, the cold front that's actually getting into New York, and the warm-up of the down south. Stay tuned as this March 11th edition of Size, Eyes, and the Skies starts right now.
It's Monday night on ISU TV. Broadcasting live from Ames, Iowa, this is Size, Eyes, on the Skies. ISU TV's longest-running television show brings you the weather around the country in Iowa, Ames, and beyond. The Iowa State Meteorology Department's team of forecasters keeps you ahead of the next weather system. Size Eyes on the Skies starts now.
Thanks for joining us on this edition of Size, Eyes, and the Skies. My name is Zach Mlock, and I'm joined here with Colleen Melberg, who will be the national forecaster later on. Colleen, what's going on in the country?
Not too much. I don't know about you, but I was slipping around on all that ice and snow this morning.
They had those ice polishers out, nice and working, as Dave likes to say. But I mean, yeah. Other than that, it was really, really slippery. At least the winds weren't too bad.
That's true. If it was really windy, I think we would have been in for a much rougher morning than we had.
Yeah, so I mean, I'm sure it was a shock to many to wake up with that much snow on the ground. I mean, obviously it started yesterday around late evening.
4:30 in the afternoon, I want to say.
And it just continued throughout then, but like I said, the winds weren't too much around the country. It's still pretty calm after that went by, right?
Yeah, but snow totals, you know, I'll talk about this later, but some places reached almost to a foot of snow all the way through Iowa, all the way up through Wisconsin towards the UP and Michigan.
Wow, that late snow is really making an impact around the country.
Yes, it is.
Well, anyways, we'll get to take a look at the Iowa's. What happened exactly right on here with our good friend over on the corner. So we'll talk to you later, Colleen. Thanks.
Sounds good.
How's Zach?
So, Iowa, what's going on?
Well, in case you somehow just came out of a hole or something, we saw some more snow yesterday.
I didn't want to see that snow, but
I was not happy when I started seeing it myself. But hey, it was a very wet snow, and that caused some very icy conditions. I saw a lot of people falling. Mm-hmm. I was lucky I did not fall myself. Mm-hmm. A couple close calls this morning.
Yeah.
But like I said just a minute ago, the snow has started to push out. And that's going to make way for some nicer temperatures for the rest of the week. And we'll go ahead and flip over to the day planner. 8 a.m. tomorrow morning, for those of us, unlucky of us, that have class at 8 a.m., 23 degrees will be the temperature around that time. And then we'll start building the clouds in as the noon hour approaches, getting up a little bit closer to freezing. Not quite going to make it for tomorrow, 31 degrees for your 3 o'clock temperature, but it will be gusty. The winds are going to increase as the afternoon continues. Mm-hmm. So, yes, the snow may be gone, but now we're going to have to deal with the winds for the next
week. Yeah, and because we don't have that sun coming out tomorrow, we're still going to have to wait another day before the snow even begins to melt off.
But once it starts to melt, it's going to go quickly.
We'll hope so. Thanks, Corey. We'll talk to you later. Well, that's going to take us to our first break. Stay tuned as Size, Eyes, and Skies continues next.
And thanks again for joining us on Size, Eyes, and the Skies. I'm Colleen Melberg. Taking a look at some of those storm snow totals from this past yesterday, I should say. Longwood, Wisconsin at 10 inches of snow, all the way down to Grand Meadow, Minnesota at 6 inches. So this storm created some, you know, hefty snow totals along the area. However, in Iowa, we didn't get quite as many. Taking a look at the warnings around the country, much quieter than we've seen for these past few weeks, I should say, where most of, like, the central U.S. has been covered. But taking a look at where some of the active warnings are, to look at Iowa right here, maybe a few flood warnings from all that melting snow and all the precip that we got from this past day. Current temps across the nation right now, 55 in Atlanta, 50 in New York, so it definitely feels like spring along the eastern coast. 36 in St. Louis and even 39 in Denver, but for a really summer feel, 75 in Phoenix, so definitely much warmer across the south. Clouds and radar right now, you can see where that cold front is pushing off into Georgia, into the Carolinas. That'll be moving through later through this evening and should be tapering off into tomorrow evening as well. So as we look at a closer view of this, you can see some of those heavier rain bands pushing through the tail end of the Appalachian Mountains and even up towards Kentucky and through that area. So definitely want to keep an eye out for maybe some flash floods of those creeks and smaller ponds. Futurecast right now, Monday this evening, see where that storm system is right now. As we move further into tomorrow, we're continuing to push off towards the Atlantic Ocean. Maybe a few spotty snow showers along the Great Lakes. Maybe some lake effect snow turtles coming through there. And further into tomorrow evening, it'll continue to push off. And maybe a few snowstorms pushing into the Ohio Valley. So maybe in the Appalachian Mountains, you might see a few couple inches of snow come into that area. Looking at tomorrow, 60 in Atlanta, 49 in St. Louis. And once again, New York is all the way at 55. So they are feeling pretty warm, much better than right now near Chicago at 37 degrees. So I know we are very looking forward to those warmer temperatures coming soon. But a closer look at the regional view, 35 in Des Moines, 32 in Minneapolis, still kind of nice and chilly, but very close to average temperatures for this time of year for us. But as we all know, spring break is coming right around the corner. And if you're looking for a destination getaway, Key West, Florida might be a good idea. Look at these temperatures, 80 on Tuesday, Wednesday, 76 degrees and sunny skies, which you can't beat that. Maybe a few isolated showers throughout the afternoon, but overall a very great forecast. And that's it for your national forecast. We'll take it back to the desk with Zach.
Man, I don't have to get my plane ticket to go to Key West, Florida. It's so cold here. I will have to just go there for spring break. Anyways, right now we're going to take a look at today's trivia question. Which of the following can Maryland and Virginia expect from a great nor'easter? Is it A, heavy snow, B, high winds, C, blizzard, or D, all of the above? That and much more is going to be coming up on this next part of Size Eyes in the Skies. Stay tuned. Thanks and welcome back to Size Eyes in the Skies. We're going to take a look at today's trivia question. Which of the following can Maryland and Virginia expect from a great nor'easter? Is it A, heavy snow, B, high winds, C, a blizzard, or D, A, B, and C? The answer is, it is D. You know, Maryland and Virginia can expect all of the above with a great nor'easter. So we're going to go over to Iowa's forecast with Corey Hargith, where there is no nor'easters, and we do have some blizzards going out of the way. Corey?
Hey, thanks, Zach. I sure hope we're not seeing any nor'easters here. Otherwise, Iowa got moved overnight and I didn't know about it. But we will take a look at some of the snow totals from yesterday. Fort Dodge was the big winner, 11 inches out of that one. Carroll and Manly both at 10.5 inches. Algona at 9, Denison 8 inches, and Sac City 7 inches of snow out of yesterday's storm. Got a couple of viewer photos here, one from our own Nathan Coy here looking towards the Campanile at Central Campus, and the second one also from campus here overlooking Friley Hall from Katie Voidick. If you have pictures you'd like to see on air, submit them on our Facebook page, and I'm sure Zach will say that one more time here at the end of the show. Right now we'll take a walk outside, 26 degrees here in Ames with winds out of the west-northwest, 16 miles per hour, and that humidity is at 81%. Current temps across the rest of the local area, 27 in Iowa Falls, same thing in Fort Dodge, 25 in Perry and Boone, 25 in Carroll, 28 in Ankeny, and also 28 degrees right now in Newton. We'll zoom out and take a look at the rest of Iowa. Mason City is in at 25, Waterloo at 28, 29 in Ottumwa, 30 in Council Bluffs, and 28 right now in Sioux City. One more time we'll zoom out and look at the entire region. It's 31 degrees right now in Minneapolis, 45 out in Pier, 50 in North Platte, and 52 right now in Hayes. So here's a look at our futurecast. There's not going to be a whole lot going on. The only thing we get to look at is this system of high pressure, and this will be affecting the entire state throughout pretty much the rest of the week. We'll just have a few clouds sitting through over the next couple of days. They will start to burn off, and then maybe a couple of snow showers up to the north are possible later in on to Tuesday, but otherwise the clouds will clear out, making way for a great rest of the week. So overnight tonight, we're looking for 17 degrees in Mason City, 18 in Fort Dodge, 21 in Sioux City, 22 in Council Bluffs, and then 21 degrees overnight tonight in Davenport. Then we'll turn around and look at tomorrow, 30 degrees for your high in Mason City, 32 Waterloo, 37 in Davenport, 35 in Ottumwa, and 36 tomorrow in Council Bluffs. So clouds and radar over the past few hours. That snow did move out of the state for the most part, maybe a little bit still up near the Mason City area. That will continue to move out of the way. Otherwise, we just got the clouds hanging out here throughout the rest of tonight and into tomorrow. Looking for 19 degrees overnight tonight here in Ames with those mostly cloudy skies and maybe a chance of a stray flurry. And those winds kicking out of the west, northwest, 10 to 15 miles per hour. Tomorrow getting back up into the 30s. with maybe a couple of snow showers, but it's not looking very likely at this point. And those winds still very strong, west-northwest at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Your 7-day forecast, once we get through that slight chance of snow for Tuesday, we clear off for the rest of the week. 31 for the high on Wednesday, but then we start getting up into the 40s. And it's looking, and I guess 40 degrees is more of a average temperature for this time of year. But then look that by Monday of spring break, 50 degrees right now for the forecasted high. I know I won't be here, but anyone that's staying here, they'll get to enjoy the warm weather as well.
Yeah, I'm excited for the 50s for sure. It's actually nice to see a 40 around here.
Yes.
I mean, for a year, for a winter of below average temperatures so far, yeah. It's kind of been just a rough one. And so hopefully no more snow. Hopefully.
So like I said, once we start melting the snow, it's going to go away very quickly. Mm-hmm. So.
But the question is, do you think we're done with the snow? We are, you know, halfway through March almost.
Yeah. Well, I
extreme snow, we're not even supposed to,
we're not supposed to get extreme amounts.
So, you know, saying about 4 inches or more is highly unlikely after, you know, mid-March. Maybe it's little, you know, flurries at nights when we get maybe still dip below freezing. That's still possible, but I mean, you can't guarantee anything. I mean, we've had a working pattern going on so far.
I know.
So.
The only thing I know, the snow, it can stay, but we need to get rid of that ice underneath.
The ice is terrible. It just sticks to everything, and then it causes disasters. Like, you almost fell
multiple times.
Well, and see, because it was so thick, and the snow was full of moisture, it was packed full, that when it was melting, because you had that blanket of snow, you know, so-called, on top of it, it was melting underneath. When they scraped it all away and moved it off of the sidewalks, and you had the little left of water that was freezing, that was initially water when you scraped it off, and then it became frozen, and it can be really, really slippery all around campus. So on the day or else you're on the ground.
All I know is when it did start to finally snow, it came down really quickly.
Yes, it did. So big flakes too, really big flakes.
I was at work yesterday and when I got there, it was still just kind of misting. Mm-hmm. Next time I look outside, we had those huge snowflakes falling.
But that warm up is on the way, so maybe spring is coming.
Yes. But
we said last week. We thought spring was on its way last week.
Yeah.
We were supposed to even see possibly higher 50s, but because that snowpack that is now on the ground.
Yep, we might still be able to see them by the end of this week, but it's looking like probably more like the 40s right now.
Well, thanks for the Iowa weather. Like right now around the country, we did have a earthquake today in California. It was a 4.7 magnitude earthquake. It still had hundreds of aftershocks, some ranging from as much as 3.7 to as low as little shocks that I barely even felt. They said it wasn't too big, though. It was only 120 miles around that was actually felt from the epicenter of the earthquake. Yeah. So it wasn't too big. Heard no one was actually injured.
Well, that's good. That's good.
Yeah, so, but still, it's kind of weird. One of those things that you never really hear. It's like, oh, earthquake, big one, somewhat big one. I mean, 4.7 isn't too bad. But just something
else
going on.
It's been a while since I think an earthquake has really occurred in California.
Yeah.
I mean, they happen.
Or anyway that I've myself.
Yeah.
They happen rarely, but they're always very small. So they said they happen, you know, daily, but can you even feel them?
But one that you can actually feel.
When you can actually feel them, then it becomes news. Which just luckily, no one was injured. There wasn't a big earthquake like back in San Francisco of the year that I don't know.
That's true.
But other than that, like us on Facebook, like us on Twitter, send us your pictures like we had from Katie Voidick of Outside at Friday with the Snow. Hopefully, the next pictures we will receive are them of flowers on flowers, budding flowers and budding trees.
There we go.
Other than that, is there any other thing we should add in here?
Have a great spring break since we probably won't see you before then. Any
going
plans?
Anywhere warm?
Well, I'm going home to Georgia, which will be warm for me.
Oh, I got you beat.
Do you?
I'm envious of that Key West forecast that you put up there.
Is that where you're going?
I'll be down there about a week or so from Tuesday, so.
You will beat me, because I thought I was going to have it nice, but how about you?
I win this one.
I'm in Indiana, so nothing is going on there.
You lose this one automatically, then.
I'm not worried about it. I'll just get some blankets, get some whatever,
and
it's fine. So, anything else? No?
Just be safe on your travels in spring break and have a good one.
We hope to see you back here in 2 weeks. But again, join us our last time on spring break this Wednesday night. Other than that, for Corey, Colleen, and myself, have a great night.